for Game 6 of the Western Conference Finals between the visitors from the Pacific Division, the Portland Trail Blazers, and your Los Angeles Lakers. And now our guests from the Northwest, the Portland Trail Blazers. At one forward, number 25, in his seventh year from Longwood College, the other forward is number 52 in his 10th campaign from Maryland, Buck Williams. At center, double zero in his fifth season from Eastern Illinois, Kevin Beckwith. At one guard, number 22, in his eighth year from Houston, Clyde Drexler. In the sixth year from Wisconsin, Stevens Point, Terry Ford. Head coach, Rick Adelman. And now, the starting lineup for your Los Angeles Lakers. Add one forward, number 14, in his seventh campaign from North Carolina, Sam Perkins. The other forward is number 42 in his ninth year from North Carolina, James Worthy. Starting at center, number 12 in his second season from Yugoslavia, at one guard, number 4 in his eighth year from Arizona State, Byron Scott. And the other guard is number 32 in his 12th year from Michigan State, Irvin Magic Johnson. Head coach of the Lakers, Mike Dunleavy.
So Dunleavy has made the decision to start James Worthy. While he's warm, wants him to test that ankle. With more, let's go to Tom Hammond.
And of course, Dick, Rick Adelman of Portland had a decision to make about his starters as well. In this case, involving Kevin Duckworth, his center, who has struggled in recent games. The idea is to get Duckworth involved in the offense early, get him to regain his confidence. But if that doesn't work, look for Cliff Robinson to come into the game. Robinson played the entire fourth quarter of Game 5 with Duckworth on the bench. Cliff Robinson could make an early entrance tonight.
Percy and Divac and Magic Johnson controls for Los Angeles. We'll keep track of that point total. 30 points a game, Lakers usually lose. 20 a game, look for them to win. Sam Perkins, you see that left eye heavily bandaged. He is not 100%.
You see a quick attempt to make a turnover right there as the Trailblazers are reacting early and trying to force the Lakers further out on the floor, four on the shot clock.
They'll have to trigger in a pass and a quick shot. So both Worthy and Perkins hobbled by injuries. Divac and Drexler with easy rebound. Gary Porter with the ball.
This is the guy that you need to key on for Portland. Terry Porter as a catalyst. And as he goes, particularly in the early part of the ball game, so will go the Trailblazers. They look inside the duck here.
Divac knocks it away, picked up by Drexler, open. Percy. James Worthy on the run. The Magic. Johnson. Oh! Swat Magic's attempt. Drexler on Johnson. Magic takes him into the paint and ties it up.
That was for that block shot.
Drexler now said, it's my turn, and he draws a foul. Johnson with Drexler, two great stars pitted against each other. With a couple inches height advantage. Scott against Porter. Worthy's first shot is not there. Percy rebounds and Porter brings him down. Knocked away by Worthy and covered by Porter. Duckworth over Perkins. The jump hook not there. That's an offensive rebound that Portland's been getting, but they couldn't hang on. And here comes Magic. Long pass. Perkins. Lakers want to slow down.
They have a mismatch, and they want to try to take advantage, but that leaves Worthy open.
James Worthy ties it at four. Worthy, their leading scorer this year, first time he's led Los Angeles in scoring in his 9 seasons in LA. Drexler over Worthy. He's a little short. Rebound Williams, but he can't tap it in, and it's Magic Johnson the other way, driving the ball down court and then throwing it away to Byron Scott.
In the games that the Lakers have won, James Worthy has been outstanding, and he seems to be doing fine right now in the early part. For Portland, they want to make a few extra passes. They're coming back to Duckworth.
Duckworth misses the jump hook, and it's out of bounds to Los Angeles. We heard Tom Hammond, if Duckworth does not play well, Rick Adelman will go to a younger, quicker lineup than Cliff Robinson, who at times can be brilliant. Duckworth gives them body and size and bulk and rebound. Tied at four. 3 minutes have been played. Underneath Divac. Good take, and then Kersey steals it. Jerome Kersey.
Porter with the mismatch against Divac.
And Divac knocks it away with his quick hand. Now picks up Duckworth. 8 seconds. Shot clock.
This is when the Lakers are very good. They force you to shoot the ball over the top of the defense, and then they allow you one shot. It's going to be a push-off, Buck Williams.
Buck Williams' first foul.
They're reacting extremely well at the defensive end, so when you've got an opportunity, you've got to make the most of it. But you've also got to have some patience, as Jerome Kersey just did against Magic Johnson.
Muscle move by Kersey for his first bucket. It's tied at 8. 6:45 left in the opening quarter. Worthy with Drexler on him now. Tough chance for Worthy. Rebound Duckworth. 2-on-2. Drexler on the drive. Williams finishes it off, and he is fouled. But Williams, the star of the game Tuesday night, gives Portland the lead 10-8. Timeout, 6:36 left in the foot of Lottie, who seems open, and they take it away from him.
Well, they're going to come back to San Perkins. Decided they're going to get somebody with a little bit more mobility and dependability. Sam Perkins feels against Duckworth for two.
Buck Williams over Divac. Little out of his range. Rebound Perkins.
More than anything else, Portland needs to see some of those perimeter shots go down. They have not been able to get that shot in when the Lakers are giving him that opportunity.
Perkins unable to hit the three. Porter to Drexler. Magic really hustled back. Ball through the hands of Kersey. Six lead changes. Blocked by Divac. Controlled by Holm. Whoops, Worthy was in that melee. Ball goes to Los Angeles, but Worthy came up limping a bit. Now he seems to be striding. 1 minute left, first quarter. Worthy. Duckworth travels. And that'll bring in Cliff Robinson.
So even though he didn't want to take him out on a negative note, the first quarter has not been a good one for Kevin Duckworth, so Rick Adelman's going to let him sit and try to find himself and Cliff Robinson into the ball game.
Now, no points for Duckworth, but another turnover, and he leads all players in the series. Sam Perkins saw the double team coming. Divac with a save. A.C. Green in the game. And he draws the foul. Portland native A.C. Green. Played at Oregon State. Foul on Drexler, his second. 15-9 in rebounds, and Divac has gotten some big ones on the offensive end. 5-4.
Lakers want to hold for one shot if they possibly can. Magic is looking at the shot clock now. About a 6-second differentiation between game and shot.
A.C. Green can't hit. Perkins tips it in. And Los Angeles opens a 9-point advantage. And A.C. Green a foul in the backcourt. His first. Penalty for Portland, and Drexler will toe the stripe.
separation in the first quarter that they wanted. Now they're forced to Trailblazers to play uphill in the second.
Drexler looking for his sixth point. And he lane violation. He was halfway to the basket when he saw that that one was going to be short. So 25-17, 8-point Laker lead, 3.9 seconds left in this opening quarter. Set the clock, 4.3,
which is plenty of time for the Lakers to get a good look at the hoop. So the Trailblazers are all up. This is where, if you're a coach, you don't want your men to break down, go to sleep, give them a cheap score.
It's going to be AC Green that takes the shot. Three-pointer. AC Green for three, and the Lakers lead by after one.
To go in the first half. The guys that have been getting it done for the Lakers at the offensive end, Sam Perkins and Magic Johnson, they come right inside to Perkins.
Got one with three fouls, and Perkins makes a tough ball away 12-footer. 14 for Perkins. Turnover. Magic has him on the run. Great pass to Perkins, no foul. Out of bounds to Portland. So that was Magic with his no-look great pass.
Some great reactions, Worthy's first, and then Kersey's back at the other end to save a great pass from Magic Johnson.
Portland down by seven, and Drexler. Hey! Saved by Duckworth, and he scores. Will be one to watch. If the Blazers are going to rally, they're going to have to do it by getting more second and third chances. Worthy with Williams. Same five that started for both teams. Worthy out there. Drexler up high for the rebound. Kersey into the hole. Duckworth has it knocked away by Scott. Recovered by Perkins.
Swear he doesn't see anybody, and suddenly the ball is gone and it's right at the rim. Sam Perkins trying to get it up, and the ball is deflected by two Trailblazers, Jerome Kersey and Buck Williams.
Magic Johnson with his 14th point off Drexler's third. And that extra free throw practice. Perfect tonight, 4 for 4. The other way with a dribble. Magic for three. Controlled in the corner by Porter. Duckworth and Stevox knocks it away. Scott with Drexler.
Drexler slipped down. The Trailblazers call a timeout.
Lakers build their lead to 9. Perkins, despite that painful thigh, deep thigh bruise, the left thigh, playing well again tonight. This is his first free throw and his 17th point to lead all scores. Lakers by a dozen. 8:45 left.
Robinson comes in and scores, but they're not sure how to do it. They don't have the passing and cutting that they had in Portland.
Seems to be a better team with Robinson on the floor the last couple of games. He immediately gives notice and has 7 points.
coaches tell you, don't play with your hands, but you see these kind of results, you can't help but applaud the players. Divac trying to hustle out of the mistake, picks up the personal foul.
Portland down by 10, 8 minutes left in the third.
The guy that's got to come to the dance for Portland is Drexler. He's got to make things happen, finds Buck Williams at the rim.
Williams with his 11th point. He's averaged only 8 in the series. Now to Magic with 10. Perkins with 3. Takes the 3. Oh, my! And the Lakers jump back to an 11-point advantage.
That is always the Sam Perkins I thought was capable of playing at Dallas, but never got those kinds of offensive opportunities. The Lakers have made the rest of the league take notice.
With the Magic before, Terry Porter answers with his own 3, has 14. AC Green ready to check in for Los Angeles. Very physical Porter.
Well, Perkins is hot and he wants to look at the rim as many times as they can. Percy trying to make the steal, picks up the foul.
Percy from the blind side has the foul and a timeout with 6. Perkins again.
Teams beginning to show a little bit of fatigue and heavy breathing out there as we go to a timeout.
Yeah, Rick Adelman noticed it as well. So Portland timeout, 3:22 remaining in the third period. The Lakers, a win away from the finals, have an 8-point lead.
Portland makes up 2 points in the third to pull within 5, and Cliff Robinson tough at both ends.
Cliff Robinson lit a spark in the Trailblazers defense with a great reaction against AC Green. Looked like Green was right at the well. You don't get any better block than that. But at the end of the period, it was Magic Johnson realizing Drexler had 4 personal fouls, putting pressure on him, getting to the rim to keep that Laker advantage at 5.
Tom was at the Laker bench during that timeout.
And they're coming back in with James Worthy, Dick. The tape on his ankle was too tight. He had it loosened a little bit. He's still having trouble pivoting in the post. They're going to try to get the ball to Worthy facing the basket.
A pick and roll, the lob to Divac, drawing a foul from Buck Williams, his 3rd. James Worthy, over 20 points in the playoffs and on the season, leading Lakers scorer, but that ankle is bothering him, and it's just a matter of how you land. You're trying to favor. You don't take off straight, and you don't land right the right way, and you're not squared up the way you'd like to.
The shooting reflects the fact that he's trying to protect it and hasn't really shot the ball well tonight.
Magic sets up Byron Scott for 2. Magic's 5th assist. He's already in double figures in points, 19 and 10 rebounds.
To find people at the rim. Again, Buck Williams right at the basket, a foul on Vlade Divac.
For Divac, that'll be his 4th. First Laker with 4. Kevin Duckworth has 4 for Portland. And so does Drexler. Johnson to score. Jerome Percy rolls Portland back to within 5. Portland so hungry for a win here to regain the home court and would be delighted to host Game 7 in Portland Saturday afternoon.
Give themselves a chance to salvage their season, which they have the best record in the NBA. Look like they certainly had a chance to win another championship.
Magic Johnson has rested only 1 minute in the whole game. Worthy! 8 points.
That's the shot they wanted to get Worthy squared up and looking at the hoop.
Drexler to Porter. Terry Porter with a good answer for the Blazers.
Turns them loose. The Lakers made all of the necessary passes. Green made them pay.
Porter pushed by it to block by Robinson, and he got a piece of the wrist, I believe. Was Kersey that got him his fourth.
Drexler has been trying to make something happen. When he penetrates, usually good things happen for Portland. Strong to the hoop. The ball barely got out of his hand before the long arm of the law, and Sam Perkins snatched it away.
Perkins, who does most everything right-handed, rights, eats. Most of his life is a righty, but in basketball, or southpaw.
Between the appetizer and the main course, he told me.
9:22 left. Perkins looking for his 25th point.
Every time Portland has challenged and got to within five, the Lakers have gotten another little spurt to push it up by nine. Let's see how Portland answers. Understand it.
for 7 now tonight, and Portland 9 for 16, trailing by only 5. Free throws, they're nemesis. And Williams gets one out of 2.
The crowd is in it now. If they weren't in it before with 6:02 to go in the ball game, they have arrived.
Two on two, Drexler against Magic. And he gets it from one end to the other. A gliding stride of his, and it's a two-point game. And timeout called by Dunleavy on the Laker bench.
Dust on it.
Anytime you're a team and you're down and you're trying to catch up, where you're going to tire first is when you look at that scoreboard and you get close, but you never get over the hill.
Short. Look at Drexler fight for that second chance, and he scores. And Drexler really taking it upon himself here in the clutch to go for the ball at all costs.
Drexler, who has been struggling for 3 quarters, seems to be coming to life here. They move down the stretch. He's got 18, 6 here in the quarter. Magic.
Oh! Now Drexler can't hit. Robinson sends Drexler the other way. A chance to tie.
Mismatch out here with Drexler against Perkins. He wants to get to the rim, make something happen.
Robinson way outside. And Byron Scott saves for Los Angeles. The Lakers lead of 2. The spot up, but couldn't hit. A little short, and there again, that ankle has to be bothering him. Drexler all the way. We have a new game, and for both teams, a season now 3:47 long.
The Lakers seem to be tiring because it was Drexler 1-on-4 on the break that tied that one up.
Drexler with 20.
Back to the quiet, steady enforcing Sam Perkins. Shot clock at 5.
Does not get the shot, but the foul is called. Adelman thought there was traveling by Perkins.
Look at the eyes of Drexler, and that tells you that he was not going to give up. Comes in down the lane. You see the Lakers just give him the lane, and he rolls it in. Drexler has struggled for 3 quarters, and suddenly in the fourth, he begins to wake up. Changes the nature of the game. His team is now down by 1. See if they double-team Drexler.
Worthy on Drexler now. Gets a pick from Robinson. Porter over Scott. Rebound, Magic Johnson, and he is fouled. Robinson on his back. Gets his 3rd.
Porter got a good look at this shot right here, and it danced on the rim, and trying to get position, Cliff Robinson comes over the top of Magic Johnson. One thing that Magic Johnson said after game 5, we got to keep our bodies between the Trailblazers and the basket. Good example of it there. Spoons out for Magic Johnson. Is this an omen? I know you got sweaty palms over here.
No.
Gets 1 out of 2. The Lakers by 2 with 3 minutes to go. Both teams way under their percentages on the season. The Lakers were 80% during the regular year.
They're looking for Drexler on this play. And what gets you a score in this situation is quick movement.
Good defense by the Lakers. Almost forcing a turnover. 4 seconds for Porter. Misses everything. Percy! An acrobatic catch and throw to tie it at 85.
Percy wanted a foul as he thought he was held as he tossed that one in the air. Now Magic has a mismatch with Buck Williams. He's going to try to score himself.
Good double team. 5 seconds past the D-box. Oh, how does he do it? Magic Johnson. 3 men surrounding him. One had his hand on the ball, and he still found the open man deep.
for Magic. And traveling on the Blazers. 2:04 left. Final 2 minutes. Crowd on its feet. To win another game in Portland is remote, and Drexler going for the ball fouls Johnson. His fifth.
Plenty of time. What the Trailblazers don't want to do is make a foolish mistake and put the Lakers on the line. They want to make the Lakers earn every score that they get, and the Lakers, on the other hand, want to use the clock and get a good look at the basket.
Press on for Portland. Knowing his defensive partner Drexler shackled with five.
Telling James Worthy to stay now, get down on the block. We want to go to Perkins
against Buck Williams. There's the double team. Here's the open man with four. Stolen by Drexler. It's a 1-point game. 23 for Clyde.
Mistake is a thing that we told you the Lakers didn't want to make, and they left that pass out there.
Magic with exactly 1 minute to go and another turnover. Porter to Kersey, and Robinson loses the ball on a 3-on-1. Oh, my. Timeout, Los Angeles. Fingertips. Clyde Drexler's wife, Gaynell, is a board of director on the Oregon Ballet. She would have enjoyed her husband's work on this steal that pulled the Blazers within one.
And it was the will of Drexler not to give up when it looked like the Trailblazers might not have a chance to get a score. They make a steal, and then they make another steal, and it looks like this is a dead bunny for Cliff Robinson, and he miscues, and it goes out of bounds. The reaction on the bench, and you can imagine what it's like in Portland right now.
That was a 4-on-1. Almost too many men were open, and Robinson didn't expect it. He thought it was going somewhere else. The pass was a little late.
Now, the Trailblazers want to play good defense. They don't have to gamble. The Lakers want to get a good score. They got to figure out what's the best place to get a score. The guy that's been doing it for them has been Magic Johnson. Got his hands on the ball now.
Hands his way into Devots, and there's a tough call. Magic could have been called for charging, or was it a block on Portland? It was against Portland's Buck Williams, his fourth.
The quick penetration by Magic to get into the middle. Kersey tried to get across. He wanted to charge there. Devots laid it underneath the glass. Now the pressure's on Devots to get them both from the line. For big guys, the first free throw is always the key. Get that first one, you got a good chance to get the second. Miss that first, you may miss them both.
Devots, not a great free throw shooter, but better in the playoffs than he was in the regular season. 78%. A 2-point game.
Now, if you're Portland, you can't go to sleep because he may miss it. The Lakers are going to try to get it. If they can't get it, they'll tip it back.
He gets them both. Well, Portland with call timeout with 43.3 seconds remaining. Portland leading every game, but when the Lakers have won, the rebounding margin has been close, and the Lakers now once way ahead in the gun. Lead by one, but that's close enough for them. As you can see, the games they've won, they only lost the rebounding race to Portland by 2-7-1.
They lead here in this series for the first time. But Portland now has 43.3 seconds. They don't need a 3-point field goal coming out of this possession. They just need a score. And they need to put pressure on the Lakers to make a good defensive decision. The Lakers want Portland to shoot the ball outside in. Portland wants to try to get a good shot going to the rim, possibly get a 3-point play on the drive. But Portland will look to get two shots in this 43 seconds for sure.
Drexler and Kersey. Threats to drive as his Porter. He has to earn that.
intended, and he hoped he'd get a foul as well. 91-90, half a minute to go.
Now, Dexter's telling his team they got to have a stop one time. Now, just looking at the clock.
12-second difference. Magic with four. Magic to Vlade. Blocked. But the Lakers get it back.
Shot clock violation.
No, they did not get, that's right, didn't hit the rim. So Portland gets the ball on the 24-second violation. So Portland timeout with 12.3 seconds left. The possession that could send it to game seven.
Thought about taking one of the rebounders out and decided they needed to get another body on the rim so they get a shot. The important thing for Portland, inbound pass. They got to get the ball.
A.C. Green in for the Lakers, a tough rebounder. Because they have no timeouts now. That would be a turnover, but it touches a Laker, goes out of bounds. There's a break for the Blazers. Good defense by Los Angeles.
Perkins with the long arm reaches out, and, you know, for big guys, the problem is always in that they're not used to this situation. Very tentative. Porter with the ball.
By Drexler. It's Porter. Not there. Rebound Johnson. He just throws it to the other end. And finally out of bounds with 1/10 of a second left. Now, do you talk about the brilliance of Magic? Rick Adelman can't believe it, thought there was a foul at the other end, but Magic fighting for the rebound and not throwing it hard, getting it down court where the clock continued to run. They're at the other end of the court with no timeouts and just a tenth of a second left.
Yeah.
Brilliant play by Magic Johnson.
Well, in this situation, Portland can only throw it to the rim and hope that somehow they can dunk it because it's not going to be a legal shot.
Johnson. Well, because Sam Perkins, a couple of minutes ago, seemed to deserve it. Sam Perkins, NBC, and Miller Genuine Draft will donate $1,000 in his name to the Thurgood Marshall Scholarship Fund. He scored 26 to lead all scorers, but the story was Magic. 25 points, 11 rebounds, 8 assists, and one over-the-shoulder Magic pass that would roll and roll and roll and take all the time away from Portland, the team with the best record in the NBA this year. The Trail Blazers are eliminated. The Los Angeles Lakers go to Chicago. It is indeed a matchup that fans and writers and broadcasters, you know, in deference to Portland's fans, a lot of it was not anti-Portland. It's just a lot of folks want to see Magic Johnson against Michael Jordan. It's a dream matchup, and so it will be.
And the bad thing is you won't be here to see it. You got to go to the French Open. Porter got a great look at the basket. That's the shot that he wanted. Magic, knowing the game situation, I wanted out of there. That's all I want to do. You see